subhanahu wa ta'ala has many, many, many beautiful names. وَلِلَّهِ الْأَسْمَاءُ الْحُسْنَى فَادْعُوهُ بِهَا. Say subhanallah when you hear the Quran. Every time say you say subhanallah, a tree is planted for you in paradise. Every time you say subhanallah, subhanallah, subhanallah. We all need the rahmat of Allah. Allah has beautiful names. His personal name is Allah. Allah. Sadly, many of us can't even pronounce it correctly. Many of us, please forgive me, can't even read the kalma correctly. I have seen Muslims in their 40s and 50s and 60s and 70s. They can't even say La ilaha illallah correctly. They can't. Sad. Very, very sad. The greatest reality in the universe is La ilaha illallah. Allah's personal name is Allah. Allah has many other beautiful names. 99 of them are very famous. The Prophet said, whoever memorizes the 99 names of Allah, فَدَخَلَ الْجَنَّةِ will enter paradise. He will go to Jannah just because of his love for the names of Allah. But out of all these other hundreds and hundreds of names, the most famous of his sifati, characteristic names are Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim. Say subhanAllah. Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim. Quran begins, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim. How great these beautiful names of Allah are. The most gracious, the most merciful. Allah's rahmat knows no end. There is no end to the rahmat of Allah. And we all need Allah's rahmat day and night. Without it, we are nothing. We cannot live for a second without the rahmat of Allah. Ala Hazrat Fazil-e Bareilvi Rahmatullahi Ta'ala Alayhi, in his Al-Malfuz Sharif, he mentions the story of a man from the previous nations who was 400 years old. How old? 400 years old. Another says that this man, his entire life he spent on an island. And on that island, there was nobody else around. No other human being. No man, no woman. So this man for 400 years, he worshipped Allah day and night. He committed no sin of the eyes, of the ears, of the hand, of the feet, because there was no sin around. There was nobody else around. All his life, day and night, Allah looked after him, providing for all his needs, physical needs. He worshipped Allah 400 years. When he was about to die, Allah sends the angel, go and remove his soul from his body. And when the angel comes, tells him the command of Allah, he says, give me 2 minutes. Give me some time. Let me refresh my wuzu and offer 2 rakats of nawafil. And when I am in the sajda position, I want you to remove my soul. The angel says, this is exactly what Allah told me you will ask for. Alimun bidati sudur. Allah janta hai na? Allah knows everything. What we do during the daytime, what we do when we lock our doors in the night, in the darkness, thinking nobody knows now. My mom and dad can't see me. Brother and sister don't know what I am up to. Allah knows. Allah knows. Allah knows the very feeling of your heart. يَعْلَمُ خَائِنَةَ الْأَعْيُنِ وَمَا تُخْفِي الصُّدُورِ. He knows the cheatings of your eyes. and he knows what you conceal in your hearts. Your mom will never know, your father will never know, brother, sister, friends will never know, but Allah knows. So this man says, give me 2 minutes, let me refresh my wuzu, offer two rakats and do this. Angel says, this is exactly what Allah told me you will ask for. So he goes into sajda, death overcomes him, and Jibreel Amin says to the Prophet Ali Salat wa Salam, Ya Rasulullah, whenever I come to visit you, I see this man in the sajda position. Allah then goes on to say, on the day of judgment, I'm trying to give you some idea of the importance of Allah's rahmat. Allah's rahmat. Who is Ar-Rahman? Who is Ar-Rahim? Both nouns of exaggeration. Asma-i Mubalagha, jiski rahmat ka koi thekana nahi, wo hamara rahmat hai. Never despair in the rahmat of Allah. A Muslim never despairs. La taqnatu min rahmatillah. Allah ki rahmat se mayus kabhi nahi hota. His rahmat is far, far, far greater than the sins of each and every one of us. No matter how sinful you are, Allah's rahmat simply is greater. Allah says, on the day of judgment, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take account of this man who lived for 400 years. How many sins? No sins, no ghibat, no lying, no deceiving, no cheating, no backbiting, no badnazari. There was nothing there. Allah will say, O angels, is habu bi abdi ila jannati bi rahmati. Say subhanallah. Allah will say, O angels, take this man, 400 years old, who worship me day and night, who never committed any sin. Allah will say, take him into my jannat because of my mercy. Allah will say, take him into jannat because I am being merciful to him. Through my mercy. This man will turn around. Say, Ya Allah, no. I'm not going to Jannah because I need your rahmat. I'm going to Jannah because I deserve it. I worship you 400 years, Ya Allah. I never committed any sin. I'm going to Jannah on the basis of my amal, deeds, action, piety. Allah will say, you think so? He says, yes, Ya Allah, I deserve Jannah because of my deeds. Allah will say, let us weigh his deeds now. Let us weigh the deeds of this man who worshipped me with ikhlas 400 years and weigh with only one bounty of mine. One ni'mat. Allah's ni'mat, who can tell me? وَإِن تَعُدُّوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْصُوهَا. Nobody can enumerate the bounties of Allah. Allah will say, only place one ni'mat of mine in one scale and 400 years of his ibadat on the other scale. बात समझ रहे हो? समझ आ रही है? अल्लाह की एक नेमत तराजू के एक पलड़े में रखी जाएगी और उसकी 400 साल की इबादत का वजन एक पलड़े में रखा जाएगा. वो नेमत कौन सी होगी? विच नेमत? द नेमत ऑफ बसारत, द नेमत ऑफ बीइंग एबल टू सी. अल्लाह विल से जस्ट प्लेस दिस वन नेमत 400 इयर्स ऑफ इबादत ऑन द अदर. व्हेन इट विल बी वेट, दिस वन नेमत will be more worthier and weightier than 400 years of ibadat. Then Allah will say, is abu bi abdi ila nari bi adli. Take this servant of mine in jahannam because of my justice. Then the man will wake up and realize, yes, Ya Allah, I'm not going to Jannah because I deserve it or because this is my amal. I will go to Jannah on the basis of your rahmat. You see, this gives you some idea of the extent of the rahmat of Allah. Nobody goes to Jannah. Never ever be of this thought that I will go to Jannah because I'm a young man, I worship Allah, I praise Him day and night, I keep an Amama Sharif, I've got a beard Sharif and I obey Him. Alhamdulillah, very good. Even that is a rahmat of Allah. You know that? There's only 50-60 of you here. What about the rest of your friends? They're not here. They're not present. Maybe they know this gathering. Why? Because because today Allah's rahmat did not come their way. Allah blessed you with his rahmat, therefore you are here. Allah ki rahmat ke bagair kuch nahi hota. कोई भी नेकी हम करते हैं उस नेकी के पीछे भी अल्लाह की रहमत चल जाती है. यू नीड अल्लाह की रहमत डे एंड नाइट. इन रहमत अल्लाह करीब मिनल मुहसिनीन. गौसे आजम शेख अब्दुल कादिर जिलानी रजी अल्लाह तआला अन्हु अनडाउटेडली इज ऑफ द ग्रेट मुहसिनीन ऑफ दिस उम्मा. He has been blessed with the maqam of Qawsiyat-e-Kubra, Qutbiyat-e-Uzma. Anyone who becomes a wali now until the coming of Imam Mahdi has to first have it endorsed by Qawsi-Azam. He is a man even in the group of the awliya. Subhanallah, in a league of his own, he himself says, Anal Hasani wal Maqta' Maqami. I am a Hasani Sayyid and my Maqam is Al Maqta'. Special Maqam Allah has given to Qawsi Azam. And then he says, Wa Aqdami ala Unuqi Rijali. And my feet are on the shoulders of the men. And who the men are, not me and you, true men. The court of Allah, the awliya of Allah. कहने में तुम हम भी मर्द हैं, आप भी मर्द हैं. क्या अल्लाह की बारगाह में जिनको मर्द कहा जाता है, मर्द. अल्लाह कहता है मर्द कौन है? Pick up सूरतुन नूर. अल्लाह से रिजालुन ला तुलहीहिम तिजारतुन वला बैउन अन ज़िक्रिल्लाह. हकीकत में मर्द वही है जो हर हाल में अल्लाह को याद कर, हर हाल में अल्लाह का जिक्र. उन्हें तिजारत अल्लाह के जिक्र से गाफिल नहीं करती. हम थोड़ी सी दुनियादारी करते तो कहते हैं नहीं बस ये समथिंग एल्स, दिस इज नॉट अ पार्ट ऑफ दी एंड दिस इज बिजनेस, दिस वी हैव टू मेक सम मनी, यू कैन डू व्हाट यू वांट हियर. ट्रू फ्रेंड्स ऑफ अल्लाह नथिंग डाइवर्ट्स देम फ्रॉम द मेंबर्स ऑफ अल्लाह. الذين يذكرون الله قياما وقعودا وعلى جنوبهم. Those who make Allah's remembrance in the standing position, in the qu'ud position, even when they are lying on their sides, they are making the zikr of Allah. Qawsi Azam is of the great muhsineen of this ummah. Qawsi Azam achieved this muqamat, of course, by the blessings of Allah and also his hard work, his effort, his struggling in the way of Allah, his mujahada, his riyadat, his struggling. He was born a wali, say subhanallah. Qawsi Azam was born a wali, and not only he was born an alim, he was born an amil. Because a wali has to be an alim. Remember this. No ghair alim can ever be a wali. A non-alim cannot be a wali. Imam Shafi'i rahmatullahi ta'ala alayh, his call is mentioned by Ala Hazrat in his Maqalul Urafa. Imam Shafi'i said, Mattakhazallahu waliyan jahilan qattu. अल्लाह ने कभी किसी जाहिल को वली नहीं बनाया. जाहिल वली हो ही नहीं सकता. इसलिए कि फर्स्ट कंडीशन ऑफ विलायत इज अल आरिफ बिललाह तआला हस्ब मा युमकिन. सादुद्दीन तफ्ताज़ाली मेंशंस शरह अकायदे दसफी, फर्स्ट कंडीशन ऑफ विलायत इज दैट मैन वुमन हैज टू हैव Irfan and knowledge of Allah. You can't be a wali if you are not a arif. First condition of wilayat is to be an arif. Al arif billahi ta'ala hasba ma yumkin. Jitna mumkin ho wo Allah ka irfan hasil kare. Koi jahil wali Jahil Bali, doesn't matter how big his beard is, and how big his amama is, and what a big rumal he's wearing, and how big the tasbih is, and which gaddi he's sitting on. If he's a Jahil, doesn't matter who his father was, whose great grandfather was. There could have been somebody great, alhamdulillah. Lekin, what are you? That's the question. बाप के नाम पे खाते हो, दुनिया चमकाते हो, दिन दुनियादारी करते हो, दुकान चमकाते हो, बाप के नाम पर, दादा के नाम पर, परदादा के नाम पर. What are you? It is about these people. अल्लामा said, अल्लामा इकबाल said, जागों के तसर्रुफ में उकाबों के नशे मन. These are crows sitting on the seats of the eagles. वो eagles थे जो तुम्हारे बाप दादा काम कर गए ना, उन्होंने काम किया है. तुम्हारे उनके नाम का खाते हो, दुनिया कमाते हो, दुनिया को उल्लू बनाते हो. Remember brothers, I'm telling you very important fact here, and you have to go and inform your mother and sisters, because they are easily caught by these deceptions, by these so-called dunyadar peers and shuyukh. First condition of being a friend of Allah is in knowledge. Irfan of Allah. Allah never makes anyone who is not an alim a wali. A wali has to be an alim. And Ghaus-e-Azam was born a wali. Others become wali later on in life by their kasb, by their efforts, by their ibadat, by their hard work. Ghaus-e-Azam, the day he was born, his vilayat was known all through Kiran. All through Kiran it was known that the son had